Hello, my name is Natalia Sharp. I'm a student at Carlisle in second grade, and these are my dinosaur questions.
Hello, Natalia. I'm Adam Pritchard, the paleontologist at the Virginia Museum of Natural History.
How do scientists know what dinosaurs looked like?
And I'll answer your dinosaur question.
How do scientists know what color dinosaurs were?
Dinosaur questions.
How do scientists know that dinosaurs laid eggs?
Is that it?
How do scientists know what food dinosaurs ate? How do scientists know woolly mammoths had fur?
Okay, that's a lot of questions, and they're all really good ones. They're actually the kinds of questions that paleontologists have to ask themselves all the time about the new discoveries and the new animals they find. Question number one. How do scientists know what dinosaurs looked like? Well, in most cases, the first thing we start with is the skeleton of a dinosaur, because that's what most of the fossils are made up of. That skeleton can be very, very complete with the entire animal preserved. Sometimes it can be only a few pieces of bone, and then it's really hard and you have to base your understanding on much more complete dinosaurs to get the whole picture. The skeletons of dinosaurs have lots of features that show that their closest relatives living today are crocodiles and birds. So sometimes we have to use the traits, the skins, the organs of crocodiles and birds to really make a theory as to what those dinosaurs looked like when they were alive. However, some dinosaur fossils are way more than just a skeleton. Sometimes we preserve the skin of the animal all over the body. Some of the largest dinosaur fossils with skin show scaly skin that was very bumpy and had big quarter-sized scales surrounded by lots of tiny little ones. These are things like duck-billed dinosaurs, some horned dinosaurs, and even some big tyrannosaurs. However, some dinosaur specimens, especially smaller ones, show that they had feathers all over their body. They would have looked a little hairier than modern birds. Still other dinosaur specimens, also smaller ones, actually have big prominent wings, like modern birds, on their arms and on their legs. And even more crazy cases, we actually have dinosaur specimens with traces of their internal organs and muscles intact. I was thinking specifically of a specimen of an animal called Scipionyx, nicknamed Skippy, that was discovered in the Cretaceous period of Italy. This little dinosaur has some of its guts, its windpipe, muscles, even a little piece of fossil feces preserved. Altogether, we have pretty good specimens to show what a lot of dinosaur skin and feathers looked like in the past. And where we don't, we can use their living relatives, the crocodilians and the birds, to make a theory as to what the rest of the animal would have looked like. Question number two, how do we know what color dinosaurs were? And this one is even harder than your first question, because there are lots of different colors in modern day crocodilians and especially birds. So we can't just say dinosaurs look like that, because you don't know if you're going to use a blue jay or a robin or an alligator to guess what the color would be. We have a very small number of those dinosaur specimens, though, that have their skin and their feathers intact that do tell us a little bit about color. Color in most animals comes from tiny molecules in the skin called pigments. Your skin and my skin have pigments that produce sort of a light pinkish color. Other humans have a little more of the same pigment, and that produces a slightly darker, browner color. Some of the dinosaur specimens actually have teeny bits of their original pigment preserved too, and with that we can see what color would have been present in some of those dinosaurs. For example, this Psittacosaurus would have had a brownish red body with sort of a pale belly. This Microraptor had black feathers, but that would have been shiny, kind of like a modern-day crow. This Sinoceratops would also sort of been brownish with a white belly, but its tail would have had this cool banded raccoon pattern. It would have been really neat looking. Most dinosaurs don't have skin, so we can't say exactly what they looked like, but with these few examples, we can start making educated guesses about the rest of them. How do we know dinosaurs laid eggs? Well, we know dinosaurs laid eggs because we have lots of dinosaur eggs from the fossil record. It's not nearly as common to find a dinosaur egg as it is to find a dinosaur bone, but we do have eggs. from lots of different kinds of dinosaurs. Sometimes you get really lucky and you find the dinosaur parent that laid the eggs right next to the nest. Other times, you find little bits and pieces of very young dinosaurs with their eggs. This is a nest from a bird-like dinosaur called Chittipati that was found right on top of her nest. She was actually sitting on it when she was buried in the fossil record. And here's a nest of the long-necked dinosaurs, sauropods, complete with a tiny little sauropod specimen that would have been smaller than a cat. And here's a nest of a duck-billed dinosaur called Myasora from Montana. These include tiny eggs to babies to full-sized adults, suggesting a big family grouping. This all fits in very well with the idea that crocodiles and birds are the living relatives of dinosaurs because all of these species in those families lay eggs too. How do we know what foods a dinosaur ate? Well, there are two main ways we go about doing this. The one way is comparing them with living animals. We have to compare the way their mouths and their teeth are put together to living animals that eat a certain kind of food. For example, dinosaurs we typically think of as meat eaters usually have very sharp teeth with sort of thin blades called serrations on each side that look like the edges of a knife. Animals that have those same kinds of blade-like teeth today include sharks, and some lizards like Komodo dragons, and those animals are really, really good at eating meat. Therefore, we make an educated guess that a lot of the dinosaurs that have teeth like that are also meat eaters too. Some other dinosaurs have sort of flatter teeth that look like they'd be good for grinding food, and those are more similar to modern day plant-eating animals. So it's a lot of those kinds of comparisons with animals that eat certain foods today. Gets really hard because some dinosaurs don't have any teeth at all. And today, animals without teeth, like the birds, can eat all kinds of different foods. So scientists are actually arguing about what some of these dinosaurs ate. Another way to tell what a dinosaur ate is to find its dinner in its stomach. And strangely, even in the process of becoming a fossil, the last meal of an animal can stay with it. If that meal contained really tough things like bones or leaves or shells or plant stems, those can fossilize right along with the skeleton of the dinosaur. Paleontologists call this sort of fossil dinner the gut contents. Some examples include small dinosaurs that have like little crocodiles inside of their stomachs, duck-billed dinosaurs with plant branches and pine needles in their tummies, and tyrannosaurs that actually have entire dinosaur bones inside of their stomachs. And finally, how do scientists know that woolly mammoths had fur? Well, to be completely honest, it's because we have lots of woolly mammoths with their fur. Much like dinosaurs, most mammoths are known only from their skeletons, so we wouldn't necessarily know what the skin of the animal looked like unless we had a really special specimen. And in some cases, we do. Many mammoths lived in very cold places during the Ice Age, like the northern regions of Siberia. And some of those places are still frozen today. When mammoths died there, some of them were frozen solid in the ice. And that not only preserved their skeletons, but their skin, their hair, and even the organs inside of their bodies. Sometimes people living in Siberia will find Ice Age animals melting out of the ice. And once that happens, scientists have to move very, very quickly to save those specimens and bring them into a stable environment in a museum, a very cold environment, so the thing doesn't just start to decay and rot and get really, really disgusting. When they succeed, the results can be magnificent. We have lots of specimens of woolly mammoths from the ice that show that the hair, the skin, the trunks of these animals, they just show how they were similar and different to modern day elephants. And not only mammoths, we have some specimens of things like Ice Age wolves, Ice Age birds, even woolly rhinoceros. Yeah, that was a thing from the ice. Natalia, thank you for all of your questions. They were really, really good. And I want you to know they're the kind of questions that scientists ask about fossil animals all the time. It's always a matter of putting the puzzle together using what you know about modern animals and bringing that back into the fossil record and using some really amazing specimens that preserve the evidence of what animals were doing when they were alive and what they looked like. So keep asking questions and keep putting the puzzles together, because that is what science is all about.